This morning, it is never too late. I don't care how long it's been. I don't care what the devil told you. I don't care what it seems like. It is never too late. In God, there's always time. And so I'm speaking about being resilient, but especially rejection. You see, for you to be resilient, we have to know, resilient is like an elastic. You have to learn to bounce back quickly from a difficult situation. Resilience, you have to learn how to be tough. And if you cannot be tough, hallelujah, in the things of God, the devil going to eat you up to pieces. He's going to dissect you and destroy you. But you see, hallelujah, hallelujah, he's scared of the one that he will try to dissect, but when he thinks he's trying to put you together, God comes in and glue you for his glory. Hallelujah. So today, as I speak, I ask you this morning to put on a resilient cover. I'm speaking about people who are ready to bounce back in the name of Jesus. Who's ready to get up and say, devil, you thought you had me. Hallelujah. But it was a mistake. Hallelujah. Devil, you made me cry. Devil, you hurt me. Devil, you disappointed me, but I took it all in to stand up for God. Where are my resilient people this morning? Where are my people who have been hurt, but you still defied the devil to stand up? Devil, hallelujah, you thought you had the best of me. You thought you would make me quit. You thought you would change my mind, hallelujah. The devil, the Bible said what? He can hurt what? The body. But not the soul. Your soul belongs to Jesus. And that's why as people of God, we have to feed the spirit. Do you know the Holy Spirit is a person? It's another being within us. And just not power. We have somebody, and that person is God within us. But when you don't know what you have within you, you cannot fully execute it to the fullness. But this morning, I've come to encourage someone who's discouraged. Someone who's sick and tired of being whipped. Someone who been, you say, God, I've been praying. I've been fasting. I've been attending church, man. I've been working for you. I'm trying, God. I'm trying, hallelujah. But what is wrong? Somebody who's sick and tired and just leaning on string, hallelujah. I come this morning to encourage you to put on a resilient covering, hallelujah. Because only the strong will survive, hallelujah. What the Bible say, from the time of John the Baptist, what happened? The kingdom of God suffered violence, but violence we must take by force, hallelujah. Who's ready to take by force? Who ready to let them talk? Who ready to look unto God, hallelujah, who is the author and the finisher of all things? Who ready to look unto Jehovah and forget about what they say? Amen. Hallelujah to his name. Oh God, hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, Jesus, he was killed. Why? He was killed because what? He was seen as a threat amongst the people of authority. You see, let me let you know. Let me wake up somebody right now. When you get in the things of God and you started to feast upon his word, you see the word of God is a meal. It's a food. That's why in the book of Psalm 23, he said, I will create a banquet. A banquet. People of God, we have a banquet. And as you start to feast on the banquet, hallelujah, whatsoever you eat, it goes in when it comes out. It shows.
Come on now.
In the physical, when you're eating so much, it becomes gluttonous. And we become overweight. So in the spiritual, when you eat it so much, hallelujah, we become anointed. And when the devil starts to smell it, he comes after you. He will use everything to reject you. Everywhere, every place to reject you. I'm going somewhere this morning. He will use until he will use your own to nail you, to reject you. Hallelujah. Because the word of God says what? Jesus was killed because what? He was threatened among our authority. So when you stand up, stop worrying about people hitting. helping you. Stop worrying about them talking about you. You have become authority in God. That's why they're rejecting you. You have become with power. That's why they can't stand you. You don't look the same. Hallelujah. You walk under the power of the living God. Stop worrying. Hallelujah. It's supposed to happen. It happened to Jesus. Hallelujah. They're going to despise you. They're going to reject you. They're going to call you all manner of name. They're going to exercise you. But I dare you, where are my people to stand up for God? I dare you to stay encouraged. I dare you this morning. I dare you, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We still, people of God, we still have a lot of work. We have a lot of work to do. We still, hallelujah. 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 We have to make intention our effort. When you make intention of your effort, you know what happens? No becomes what? A vitamin. Amen. Well, when no seems a rejection for somebody, I don't think you got me. When no is a rejection for somebody, it becomes what? A vitamin for you. Hallelujah. It becomes, because the vitamin is going to energize you for strength. Yes. When other takes no and walk away, you take no and say, I'm going to try again. I'm going to knock again. I'm going to push again. I'm going to, hallelujah. I'm going to go again. I'm going to go several times until I get a team. Hallelujah. My desire goal. We got too far to go. This yesterday, I'm looking on TV, and there was this documentary where, I've forgotten this gentleman. It's going to come back tomorrow as I speak. But he was talking about a young man and women in prison. He was talking about the rejection. He was talking about slavery, the mentality, the insight. He talks about from the get-go America. He went into politics. He talks about how you, hallelujah, you can go out and portray what's been engrafted into you. And from the foundation, the seeds of rejection always been. He talks about the shades of complexion. He talks about, hallelujah, undermining people, calling them means, lower to a peasant, a slave mentality. He talks about when you grow in such environment, that's not strength. All you know to do is to work at a failure mentality. You undermine yourself, hallelujah, because from the day you were born, they tell you that you're no good. Every effort you made, you've been rejected. Some been abused. Some been abused, and when they stood up for themselves to speak about it, they were rejected. At times they say, you are lying. It's not true. Hallelujah. 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 And so what? It fractures you. It's a fragmentation. It weakens you. It stops you from being your all in all. You underestimate who you are. It creates a low self-esteem. You devaluate yourself. You don't love yourself. And that's what Jesus came into place. Because you get into a place, you wonder, hallelujah, hallelujah. Do you know there are many, even who were highly educated today, but there is a child living within them? Do you know that? They have the profession. They can wear it.